Mr. Calvin Castine, it's May 24th, 2002, and we're at Northern Adirondack Central School, beautiful downtown Ellenburg Corners. We're looking around trying to find our earpiece so we can make sure our sound is coming through, but we don't see it, so we're going to have to hope that we're coming through to you loud and clear. This is first round action, quarterfinal play. I believe it's quarterfinal. Could be semi, but I believe it's quarterfinal play in Section 7, Class C competition. Tupper Lake is the visiting team. Northern Adirondack Bobcats are the home team. This is Kristen Canning pitching. Up the middle, base hit. First batter was Arsenal. That there was Fletcher right there. Going to first base. And this will bring up Swoboda, the shortstop. Audrey Swoboda. Let's see. Pitching, as we said, is Canning, Kristen Canning. Her battery mate is Amber LeClaire. At first base is Krista Jubert. Second base is Madonna Bertrand. Shortstop, Shea Gilmore. Jackie Fennessy's at third. It's popped up to shallow left field. Dekos is going back. Makes the one-handed grab. On left field is Amanda Dekos. Center fielder is Ashley Benware. And Stephanie Barron is in right field. Or is that Danielle Barnaby out there? This is Jones, on two outs. Strike one, says Kevin Prey. Popped up to the left side. Squeezed by Fennessy. Nothing across after one half. It's Tupper Lake nothing. Bobcats coming to bat. Rather sparse crowd to begin the start of this game. Whatever. Sparse crowd at the moment. A couple more arriving. People funneling in. Krista Jubert at the plate. Swings at the first offering. Hits it. Foul. It's going to go out of play. Strike one. Rodriguez is the pitcher for the Lady Jacks. 1-1. Her battery mate is Arsenal. First base is Jones. Second baseman is Fletcher. Ball two. Shortstop is Swoboda. Third base, it's Kentel. In the outfield, Mace, Kentel, and Martin. There are two Kentels in the lineup. Off the fist, off the handle of the bat. Unassisted putout at first base by Jones. So Jubert is erased and Shea Gilmore will step in. Gets the instructions from Coach Tim Drillette down the third baseline. Strike one. Rain threatening. And we have a few mosquitoes and other varmints floating around. The game earlier today at Beekmantown had a strong wind, so we didn't have any insect problem there. It's fouled back and out of play. 1-2 the count. Changeup is lined into center field. It'll be a base hit for Gilmore. And she's on with the single. Brings up the second baseman, Madonna Bertrand. Strike one.
Baby, you gotta break back up and throw to first.
That'll get away and that'll allow Gilmore to go to second base. So the runner in scoring position and one out. It opens the door for the Cats. This will go out of play, so Gilmore gets another base. A pitched ball that goes out of play. It is a one base. However, as we saw earlier today, there's a line drive base hit. That'll score Gilmore, and on the RBI single is Bertrand. And I'll bring up the cleanup batter, Amber LeClaire, the catcher. So earlier today in the Beatontown Saranac game, there's a strike. The pitcher made a pickoff move to first base, threw the ball out of play, and the runner went from first to third. So when the pitcher is a fielder, it's two bases on an overthrow, just like everybody else. But on a pitched ball, it's one base. Bertrand scores. LeClaire ends up at second base, and Cats are leading 2-0 in the early going. Now Jackie Fennessy swings and misses, strike one. And we're going to have LeClaire moving up to third base. Still just one out here in the first inning. Pitch from Rodriguez, swung on, hit to deep center field. This will score the run. LeClaire will score easily and make it 3-0. So it's a sacrifice fly RBI for Fennessy. Now left fielder Amanda DeCoste at the plate. She takes the first pitch high for ball one. Hits sharply to third, nice charity hop, fire to first. In time, so it goes from Kentel to Jones for the out. Cats pick up three, they lead 3-0. We're going to the second inning. Now this is the pitcher Rodriguez leading off in the top of the second. Canning's first pitch is ball one. Ball two. We have Barron in the outfield and right field this time. She and Barnaby apparently are switching in and out defensively. Not quite sure how that DP works, but apparently Coach Drillette knows and is. She circled it, but couldn't get a handle on it. It brought joy to her teammates. That's good. Canning's pitch. It back under Canning's glove to second base, throw to first. In time, it was Madonna Bertrand making the play. So that's two down, and Mace will step in. She's a left fielder. Shannon Mace. First pitch to her is ball one. Strike two.
One ball, two strikes.
Oh, but interesting if she'd hit that ball. It wouldn't have gone very far. That one there is foul.
Hey, be smart, right?
1-2. Change up. Strike three. Caught her flat footed. So that's two down, and it'll bring up the right fielder, Martin. Comebacker to Canning. Tosses over to first to Joubert for the out. Three up, three down, nothing across for Tupper Lake. After an inning and a half, it's 3-0 Bobcats. All right, at the plate here, we've got Stephanie Varon. That's high. It's in the dirt. She's getting a beating here. One off her knee, that one off her helmet. Two and two. That's the full count. First batter in the bottom of the second. Here's the pitch. It's going to be low. Ball four. So Varon will go to first. We're going to bring up the center fielder, Ashley Benware. Varon's going to go out of play, and we're going to send Varon to second base. It'll be ball two, and Varon will go to third base. 2-0 the count, nobody out here in the second. That's ball three. Benware will be taking all the way, and she takes a strike, 3-1. That'll be ball four. And Benware will coast to first base, no attempt to go to second. So runners at the corners, and the pitcher Kristen Canning, the batter. But still nobody out. Canning swings and misses, strike one. And Benware does not attempt to steal. Foul off, that'll be strike two. Line shot, ooh, double play. Looked like it was going to be up the middle, a line shot. Right back to the pitcher, Rodriguez. Now the runner at third, Varon, could hold up. Benware, thinking that was going to be through, had to take off, and she's double up, so it's an easy double play on a hard hit ball, and it'll bring up Krista Joubert. So suddenly, the circumstances have changed. Instead of runners at the corners and nobody out, it's a runner at third and two outs. Because of the weather we've had this year, not given, not able to give the coverage that we normally like to give to the spring sports. It's ball four. Well, Joubert will go to first, and he'll stay there. And I'll bring up the shortstop, Shea Gilmore. Ball one. See if Joubert will steal. It's a good time for a steal right here. It's fouled. Hit sharply to third. And we're gonna have a, she kind of slowed down. Gilmore is safe, but she slowed down as she approached first. Can't do that. Her father, Paul Gilmore, coaching at first, saying, run through, run through. So that gets Varon in. And it brings up Madonna Bertrand. Bertrand hits the first pitch hard to short. And we're gonna have everybody safe, another run in. For the Bobcats, they lead now 5-0. Bertrand will reach on the E6. And now Amber LeClaire will step in. Cleanup batter, catcher. Looks a strike one. First and second with two down, two in. In the second. Off the handle, it's going to drop in, a little flare to right field. It's going to get away in right. That's going to score at least one, maybe two. They'll be at the plate. Bertrand scores. And LeClaire is going to end up at third base. So that makes it 7-0 in favor of the Cats. And Jackie Fennessy stepping to the plate. She looks at ball one. It's going to go... Ooh, nice stop by the catcher. Kept the ball and herself in play. If she had caught the ball and stepped out of play, runner on third would have scored. Because the ball would have gone out of play. That's high. Gets away. And the run scores. LeClaire scores from third base. And I believe that's now... That just might be... Let's see. Yeah, I think that's 5 runs in this inning to make it 8-0. Eighth batter of the inning at the plate. Bases are empty. There's 2 outs. So that's 3 batters and 5 is 8. So Fennessy walks. Gives the Cats a base runner and bring up the 9th batter of the inning, Amanda DeCoste, the left fielder. Fouls it off, strike one. Strike. That's high. 1-2. Rodriguez pitch down the middle, strike 3. So the Cats pick up 5, they lead 8-0. We're going to the 3rd inning here on Hometown Cable, Section 7, Class C, quarterfinals. That's a ball hit to 3rd base, over to 1st. That was Fennessy to Joubert, that batter. Was Kentel, and here's the other Kentel. Top half of the 3rd, and we were busy visiting with Ralph Cross, the sectional chairman, is filling us in on the next rounds. That's 2 down. And now Arsenal, the catcher. Ain't nothing in the top half of the 3rd. Grass cutter to short. Gilmore to Joubert. Quick, very quick. 1-2-3 inning. We go to the bottom of 3rd. 8-0 Cats. This is Danielle Barnaby, and she takes strike one to start the bottom of the 3rd. Swings and misses, strike 2. Overcast day, but all in all, not unpleasant. Hit to 3rd. Bob will throw to 1st in time. And Barnaby kind of slowed down. Cats can't do that. You got to run through there. Here's Ashley Benware, the center fielder. Gonna run through first base. Want to slow down as you approach. Ball one. Rodriguez making the catcher Arsenal work hard today. Cats with 3 in the 1st, 5 in the 2nd. Three and one to count. That's ball 4. Well, Benware will make her way to first base. And get us to Kristen Canning. And Benware will go to second. Yes. Winner of this game goes to Ticonderoga.
Don't help them out now. Come on, put the ball right in there.
They face the Sentinels in the semifinals. Soft liner to center field. It's going to drop in. That's going to put runners at the corners. So the Cats are threatening again here in the third inning. Top of the order up. This is Krista Joubert. She swings at the first offering, hits a fly ball to third for the second out, squeezed by Kentel. And it'll get us to shortstop Shea Gilmore. Pitch to her is ball one. It'll put runners at second and third. Sun peeking out. In tight. Two outs here in the third inning. No advance. Catcher Arsenault keeps it on the third base side. 2-1 to count. Chopper to short. Gilmore is going to reach. Cats will score a run. The shortstop, Swoboda, came up quick on that ball. It was not a slow bouncer, but it wasn't a hard bouncer either. This is Madonna Bertrand. She fouls off the first offering, strike one. So Swoboda ended up kind of one of those where you were anxious for the ball to get there and you pick up your glove before the ball gets there. Runners at the corners. It's a fair ball. This is going to score a run. Gilmore's going to go to third. She'll be held up and safe at second with a double. There's Madonna Bertrand. An RBI double makes it 10-0 Bobcats. Amber LeClaire at the plate. Second and third. Here's the pitch. Strike one called. Foul ball.
Stay ahead of her, let's go.
Two strikes the count. That's ball one. A lot of hustle from Arsenal. She's getting a workout. There's Rodriguez pitch. Gilmore will stay at third. With a 10-0 lead, Cats aren't going to take any chances. Somebody getting hurt trying to score a run. Ooh, just missing. Ball three. So that makes it a full count. And a pitch. Foul tipped. Count holds at 3-2. And pitch from Rodriguez. That's ball four. And it's going to go out of play. And a run will score. Now Jackie Fennessy steps in. Pitch to her. Swung on. Going to be in between her. And she's going to chase home a run. With LeClaire stopping at third. And get us to Amanda DeCost. Once again, the ninth batter of the inning. Two outs. Foul off. I'm sure DeCost would like me to point out that she's made the last out in the first and the last out in the second. And she has a chance to make the last out here in the third. A rare opportunity. Rodriguez pitch swings at a high offering. A little bit out of the strike zone. I think she knows it. One and two the count. Lays off that one. Two and two. Swing and a miss, strike three. Well, we go to the fourth inning. And we'll add up the runs. Bobcats leading the Lady Lumberjacks. All right, at the plate here is Fletcher, the second baseman. And she lines it off the glove of DeCost in left field. Oh, heck, we'll give her a hit. Well, Fletcher's on it first. Happy as heck to be there. And get us to the shortstop, Swoboda. Audrey Swoboda. Pitch from Canning, high, ball one. 12-0 Bobcats in the fourth. Fouled off. Ball four, Swoboda walks, so we have runners at first and second. Nobody out. And we got us a lefty hitter here. This is Jones, cleanup batter. Strike. Fouled, out of play. Looks like we have one practicing to be a beekeeper here. Trying to keep the black flies off, I guess.
One ball, two strikes.
Line shot to center field, it's gonna drop in. We're gonna have the bases loaded. So, Lady Lumberjacks threatening here with nobody out in the top of the fourth. Gets us to the pitcher, Rodriguez. Base is full, nobody down. Here's the pitch. Swings and misses, strike one. Comebacker. Come to the plate. Gilmore's throw comes in. Runner did not slide. Two runs score. Close play at the plate. Runners are supposed to slide.
Okay, Amber.
That ball was fire.
McClair was running too. I'll make it 12-2. And bring up Mace. One to count. Swing and a miss. Strike two. Two and two the count. Runners at second and third. Nobody out. It's a foul ball. 12-2 the score in the fourth. 3-2, LeClaire doing a juggling act. 3-2 the count. Goes after ball four. First base is unoccupied. She is swinging at a bad one. Nice job by LeClaire coming out there and firing a strike. Whoop, whoop, whoop. Be careful tossing that helmet. Especially when the umpire is looking at you. This is Martin, the right fielder. One out. Ball one. Strike. Two balls and a strike. That'll be strike two, foul ball. Nice pickup at first by Joubert. I believe it's a full count. Here's the pitch. Right down the middle. No, off the base. Ball four. That'll load the bases. Bases are full for Kentall, the center fielder. Hit sharply to short. Gonna get the out at third. Good play by Gilmore going to Fennessy. Gets the force. Got the shore out. So that's two down. Another run scores to make it 12-3. Now the other Kento steps in. Strike. One pitch. 3-1. Ball four is going to load the bases and bring up the top of the order. Catcher Arsenal will step in. Arsenal becomes the ninth batter of the inning. Strike one. So three in, three out. It's going to be three and two out. I'll be all right. Hit to second, throw to first in time. Goes from Bertrand to Joubert. Three runs for the Jacks. They trail 12-3. Halfway through the game, we're going to the bottom of the fourth.
All right, let's go. Put ball right in there now. Let's go.
Stephanie Varon will step to the plate and lead off the bottom half of the fourth. Cats are making some changes. We'll try to pass them along as we get to them. Oh, 12-3 Bobcats. Quarterfinal play. Three and oh the count. Strike called. Well, he's lays off ball four, so Varon will get a free pass. She'll go to first base. And Ashley Benware will step in. It's a chopper off Rodriguez's glove. Yeah, everybody's going to be safe. Good recovery by Svoboda. That's one where it would have been better for Rodriguez to let it go, but she thought she could handle it, so she put her glove out there. The ball's going up the middle, and that's where Svoboda broke. When the ball deflected, she had to break the other way. This is Kristen Canning. She looks at ball one. Both runners will move up. Barron to third, and Benware into second base. Nobody out for the Cats. They've scored in every inning thus far. That's hit to third. Gonna come to first, get the out. That's what you gotta do. Barron scores. 13-3 the score. And top of the order now, Krista Joubert, the batter. Joubert at the plate. Runners at the corners. Here's the pitch. Swings at one way out of the strike zone. That'll put runners at second and third. If there were a runner at first, it would have put runners at second and third. But of course, there was no runner at first, so no harm. Line shot off the shin. Oh, that's going to hurt. Right off the top of the shin, or the, excuse me, off the top of the instep or off the shin. The third baseman, K. Kento reached down and the ball went under her glove and hit her off the foot. Here's Shea Gilmore. 14-3 now, Bobcats lead, and we're going to have a runner at second base as Jubert rounds second. Cats will be making a couple of changes. We'll try to pass those along. Hopefully we'll pick them up. Jubert advances to third. That's a ball. Strike called. 3-1. I think that was a situation strike here. Gonna make these players hitters. Back to Gilmore. Gets by her. To Swoboda. Fires to first. Will not be in time. It's gonna go out of play. And Gilmore will get second. And Jubert will score. And Janessa Rounds will step in. She's in for Madonna Bertrand. Ball one. Gilmore goes to third. Two and all the count. Pitch from Rodriguez. Foul tip. Makes it 2-1. Foul tip. Taken by the pitcher, Rodriguez. Two down, and Amber LeClaire, the batter. Eye for a ball. To second base, one-handed by Fletcher. Cats pick up a couple. They lead as we go to the fifth inning here in quarterfinal play, Section 7, Class C softball. A little first ball hitting here. We're busy visiting. And what we got here? That was Fletcher. This is Swoboda. Fletcher's on. Strike one. Another seeing eye hit here, right down the line. That's going to be extra bases. Fletcher will stop at third. Second and third, nobody out. Al Jones at the plate. She swings at the first offering. Jubert calls. We have one down. Yeah, let's see, gets us to Rodriguez, the pitcher. Strike one. Chop to the left side. Gilmore goes to first. Run scores. Get the outs, that's what you gotta do. Got the lead, another run from the other side, doesn't matter. Cats are up 14-4 now. This is Mace, the left fielder, strike one. Oh, this is Amel at the plate. Amel. Light swing. One and two. And Sabota's going to score. 2-2 the count. Strike three. Drop third strike. Drop third strike. And she's out. We go to the bottom of the fifth. 14-5 probably. Bobcats leading. Jackie Fennessy, the batter. Hits the first pitch to first base. And Jones will grab it. One down. I bring up Amanda DeCost. Ball one. Strike. Hit to third. Throw to first, and DeCost is out. Two down. Danielle Barnaby. That's the first pitch. Foul ball. Foul ball right down the line. Third baseman was going for it and curved on her, and she was going to touch it whether it was going fair or foul. So break there for the Lumberjacks. Two outs, nobody on. Cats scored every inning thus far. That's high. Strike. 1-2 the count. Picked that one out right off the ground. Oh, definitely going to be ball two.
Nice job, girl.
So, Barnaby is out. We go to the sixth inning. 15-5 is the score. 14-5 is the score. All right, we got Martin at the plate as we start the sixth inning. Strike one. 14-5 the score. Swings at a high offering. Foul ball, strike two. 0-2 the count. And Canning winds and delivers. Line drive, nice catch by DeCost. Heck of a play by the second baseman. Took a base hit away. Backhanding it. This is one of the Arsenal girls. She's batting for one of the Kentol girls. Ball one. One pitch, popped up. Jubert's there, two down. And it should be the this is the other Kentel. To Jubert at first. Three up, three down, nothing across for Tupper Lake. We go to the bottom of the sixth. 14-5, NAC leads. All right, we're in the bottom of the sixth. This is Ashley Benware. Ball one. Ooh, strike called. Hit Back to the pitcher. Rodriguez goes to first. One down. Kristen Canning takes strike one. One and one to count.
No catch.
Oh, Canning will reach and bring up Joubert. Starting to get a sprinkle or two here. Rain's held off nicely. Fouls it. Out of play. It's a grass cutter to Swoboda. She's going to go to second, and everybody's going to be safe. Brings up Shea Gilmore. Pitch from Rodriguez, strike one. Gets away, and we're going to have runners at second and third. One and two the count. Line drive. Safe. Good try by the third baseman, who may or may not be Kentel. Line drive by Gilmore. Now Janessa Rounds steps in. Two outs. Here's the pitch. Line drive, that's going to drive in a run.
Watch the runner.
Rounds reaches. Runners at the corners. Canning scores. Make it 15-5. And Amber LeClaire, the catcher, will have to take off her shin guards. And she's set. It's a hard shot through the right side. And another run scores and make it 16-5. Well, Jackie Fennessy, the batter. To right field, it's going to drop in. What the heck? Amber LeClaire not running on that with two outs. No excuse. Force out, run does not score. We go to the top of the seventh. 16-5 the score. The catcher Arsenal will lead off the seventh inning. Looks at ball one. Cats looking to wrap it up, advance to face the Ticonderoga Sentinels. Section 7. Class C semifinals, Shea Gilmore with a nice running grab. One down. Now Fletcher. Or at least the position that used to be Fletcher's. I haven't heard it's not Fletcher, but. It's fouled. One pitch. Three and one now. Strike two. Full count. Payoff pitch. Line drive, that's a base hit. Fletcher is on, and it'll bring up Swoboda.
Bethany's in the game, somebody else.
Ball one. Strike. Two balls and a strike. One out. Line drive, another base hit. Throw to second. No throw to second. Throw goes to first. Should have looked at second. Lefty hitting Jones. Ball one. Two-oh pitch. Hit to second. Dikas goes to first. Got the shore out. Not a bad idea, although she had a lot of time to go to second on that one. Got the shore out. Now Rodriguez at the plate. Runs the second, third, the last hope here for the Lumberjacks. Ball one. I want to remind our Bobcat fans that this is viewer-supported television. We get precious little support out of the Ellenburg, Altona areas for some reason. Three and oh. First base is open. Swings at the sweet 3-0 pitch. Canning will fire to Joubert for the out. And that's the ball game. The NAC Bobcats defeat the Tupper Lake Lumberjack, and that's the way it was on this 24th day of May 2002. You've been watching Hometown Cable Television. That's worth your support. Our thanks to those of you who are watching and supporting Hometown Cable's ongoing efforts.